What is good, Diamond Dynasty, baby? Welcome back to another motherfucking video.
There's a lot of girls with me right now. Got a lot of drugs with me right now. But I'd rather just get
like, let's not go too soon now.
Feel the same. And a lot of girls hit it mine now.
Hey,
I would rather pass that one to you like we used to do.
And today, babe, y'all already know what the fuck going on in this goddamn video. So today, as you can tell by the title of the video, we are going to get a little bit spicy, or maybe not spicy, I don't know. You guys have been wanting me to react to. I asked supporters to give us questions to ask each other by Ms. Mila J, 4K in the building. And we got Chrissy, motherfucking Danielle, in the motherfucking building. Without further ado, we're gonna go ahead and get straight into this video, man. If you have not already, make sure you join the dynasty, baby, and subscribe to my YouTube channel, like this video, comment your thoughts and opinions down below. Share this video with a friend, hit that bell so you can be notified every time I post another lit ass video. Make sure that you DM me at the real Diamond M and let me know what I should be reacting to next. And tell a friend to tell a friend to tell they ain't your mama, tell they Uncle Joe. That nigga still a hoe. Let's get right into this motherfucking video, y'all. Let's get it.
What's good, 4K gang? So today I asked people to ask me questions to ask Chrissy on Instagram, and I asked her to post it too so that she can ask me questions.
Okay, we get it, bro. We get it.
About yourself.
All right. There we go. There we go. We got it.
Okay.
We got it. All right. Let's keep it going.
Getting your nails done, getting Starbucks, or tattoos?
No more nails, Starbucks, or tattoos. Nails.
So you can do your nails for the rest of your life. You won't have no tattoos no more. And no Starbucks. She canceling Starbucks.
Look, nails are sexy as hell. All my fams out there, all the fams out there who are watching this video, I want you to comment down below and let me know if you get your nails done, baby. Do you get your nails done? I just need to know, okay? I need to know if you get your motherfucking nails done, because I think that is sexy as shit. I say it all the time. All right, I recommended that Dominique Wilson get her nails done. Now that she got her nails done, she a whole motherfucking vibe out here, you know what I'm saying? She over here vibing on niggas and shit, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to all the women who take their precious time, okay, to get they motherfucking nails done, okay? That's all I'm gonna say. Shit.
I had to have my nails, bro. I thought I would feel so good.
Even though you miss one every now and then, it's all good. You know what I'm saying? We fucks with you, alright?
She always, like, the other day I was trying to get my nails.
It's all good, you feel me?
The other day, a couple of
weeks
ago, and she's like, no, I like your long nails, so I feel forced. Maybe you
don't
like them.
Check them off.
No, it's just because they keep falling off. Can I do like this?
They keep falling off.
Comfortable.
Hey.
Why would someone ask me that? Like, I don't know the answer to that. And I'm not gonna ask.
Okay.
It's
okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Hey. Come on, Whitty.
Rate your head game.
Oh, like, shit. Head game, 12 and it's big. You know what I'm saying? No, I'm really a 2.
I'm a 10. I'm very confident when it comes to that.
Yeah, the 10 is a fuck up.
Because you know.
Oh.
Why are you thinking like that?
Oh.
I'm talking about
when
we have
our oh. Oh, it's now. Oh.
Yeah. I'm mm-hmm.
You know, she told me when we first met that she didn't know how to give head. And she kept me going for a minute. And I was so sad. Like,
look, okay, I'm a 2, my nigga, you know what I'm saying? I don't know what I'm doing, so somebody show me the way, you feel me?
Like,
show me the way.
Now, like, knowing, that's the shit. Come on.
Shut the fuck up.
Show me the way, baby.
Okay, question number 2.
Dos.
I just want to fight you. You're like a fucking child. Damn.
Do you see a change in me since we started talking?
That's a good
like
question.
What?
Like, do you see anything that's changed?
That's a good question.
Like, what? In a negative way or a positive way?
What'd she say?
I don't know. I wouldn't consider consider it a negative way, but I just feel like it happens like every time you more long to get to know people.
What though? What changed?
What? You'd be on your phone more.
Oh shit.
What would you do if I wanted to have a baby right now?
Chrissy Danielle says she ain't getting enough time, attention, love, or care. She not getting enough TLC, baby. She said at this stage in their relationship, Miss Mila J4K cares way more about her phone than Chrissy motherfucking Danielle. I don't know, guys. Hold on. What it say?
What would you do if I wanted to have a baby right now?
These are some good questions.
I don't know. It wouldn't be like a bad thing. I wouldn't care. That's for sure.
Chrissy, like, you over here flexing, bro.
Yeah, I'm gonna break up with you.
That is a lie.
Like, say I want to try to get pregnant right now.
I'm thinking in my mind that they're both thinking about Dominique Wilson. I could be wrong, but I think both of them low-key are thinking about Dominique Wilson because that was the situation. Damo basically, in a way, gave Chrissy an ultimatum without giving her an ultimatum, but still it was an ultimatum because they were supposed to be together. That means they make decisions together. But if you didn't consider somebody's decision and you just did what you wanted to do anyway, even given the situation that you knew from jump that this person wanted to have a baby regardless, still though, you knew how everybody was gonna look. Anyway, that's a whole other situation, but I feel like Miss Mila J don't want to say the wrong thing. She don't know what the right thing is to say because Chrissy just went through that situation. Y'all leave me a comment down below and let me know. I might be thinking too far into this. I don't give a damn, okay? That's just me. I'm a deep ass thinker. You know I like to go deep, no pun intended, all right?
To deal with that type of responsibility.
Some ice cream.
How long could you hold your breath for?
I don't know. Let's find out.
No.
Right.
No, I can't.
Just let her do it, nigga.
Okay,
bitch. All you gotta do is breathe through your mouth, bro. Oh my gosh. You ain't even got the phone?
What the fuck?
She act like she couldn't breathe out her mouth. Yeah, you would have died underwater, bro. You do not need to be lost at sea.
Fucking hand like you got a
plaque on. She ain't gonna make it.
What the fuck? She can hold her breath for 12 seconds. She going in the water.
When you first seen me in person, what did you think of me?
When I first saw her, I was like, she is so tiny.
You was it.
And I had to. That was it. I swear to God. I see her pop out this big ass range. So I was like, that was so attractive. She's so tiny.
That was so attractive. Oh, that range was probably real attractive. Shit. I ain't gonna hold you up.
And then when I heard her voice, the first time I heard her voice, it was cut. I
knew.
I just knew.
I just knew.
And then when I heard her voice, remember, when I first heard her voice, I was like,
Damn,
she got that.
I remember she told me she was gonna take me on a date to the taco place because I told her I was pulling up at Taco Bell and she said Taco Bell's nasty. And then
Taco Bell is the shit, my nigga. Like, I fucked with Taco Bell.
And I was like, okay, what is it? Do you love cooking for me? Like, do you like cooking for me?
I genuinely love it.
Do you really?
I love it. I love it for you because I like your reactions. I like compliments, especially for my girl. So if you think I can cook, And it's just a plus. It just makes me feel like a lot more confident in myself.
So I'm gonna try to cook so I can make you feel good. Can I cook?
It don't matter, but you make me feel good.
I like when you call me my girl. I mean, like, you know what I mean? When you say my girl. I've never, like, I don't think everybody in here has ever called me that. Like, say my girl.
Who? So, Macarena.
You gotta make it different. You gotta make it real spicy.
Oh, I'm just scared. You're so bad in your face, and I was looking at the whole time you stopped me, but anyway,
oh, yeah, I'm gonna post that, I'm gonna record that scan routine. You can scan stay flawless.
You should. Yeah. Ooh, you're so fucking fine.
Like, where do you see me?
I see you successful. I see you in a really nice car, or at least a car that you really like.
What kind of car? What car do you see me with?
I see you with a Jeep.
I don't want a pink Jeep so bad.
And I see you really successful on YouTube because I just see how much you like it and where I've invested in it. And I see you with me.
Drinking.
In our houses. Yeah. With our beds. We don't have a good one.
I feel like these two, they're just a real chill ass couple, so it comes off as boring. I think that's the main thing. Both of them are two chill ass people. The energy is just chill, but it can also be perceived as boring. You know what I'm saying? Maybe their freedom of expression or their range of expression isn't all the way there, or I don't know. You guys let me know in the comments down below. Do y'all think that they're just two chill ass people? That's what makes their videos a little boring? Or, you know what I'm saying? Why do you think they say that Miss Mila J and Chrissy Danielle are boring together? Okay. And it might even be because people are comparing it to Damo and Chrissy. Damo and Chrissy's vibe, I think, was, you know what I'm saying? It was just different. And of course, Damo brought a lot of energy to that relationship. So it wasn't ever a dull moment dealing with Dominique motherfucking Wilson. So in comparison to her previous relationship, of course, people are going to say that this new one is boring. Y'all leave me a comment down below. Let me know if you agree or disagree.
You want a stinky ass rabbit?
How'd you want a bunny? No, I don't know. That's not what I'm thinking about. I was thinking about a bunch of pets. Like, I just want, like, I want a fish tank, like a really nice. We should put the fish tank in the fucking movie theater. That would be cute. Hold on, I have to write
that
down.
Oh.
My mind is...
I know, she want to get everything perfect. You going to post a video on that?
Yeah.
I got to turn into that too.
Fish tank for movie theater. What's your favorite TV show?
Right now, It's going to be the Twilight Zone.
Oh yeah, I thought that should be mine.
They just be made it, Jordan Peele, so that shit, y'all gotta tune into that.
That shit is crazy.
Told him to put me in on that.
You said it comes out every what?
Every Thursday on CBS. Every Thursday on CBS, the Twilight Zone. It's interesting as fuck.
I cannot get into shows. Oh, I cannot get into shows, y'all, but there's this one show on Hulu that my nigga put me on about the little girl who killed her mom because her mom had her believing that she had cancer. Let me know in the comments down below if y'all have seen it. It's called The Act. I believe it only has one season for now, and I watched all the episodes. And yeah, that motherfucker there was live, okay? And it's based on a true story. That's what type of shit I like. I don't like the sci-fis and all this shit that's not really real. I like shit that is based on a true story. You feel what I'm saying?
From beginning to end, you know what I'm getting at. I like shit that can make you think.
Think, yes. What you talking about? When we get this crib, When you get this crib, like, and you can, like, sit down and watch TV every day, I'm gonna start recording stuff.
All right, bro.
And my erections is high. They're 100 inches.
What? What? Your earwax was that high?
Why you got down here?
Is that all we got?
What's the fake picture of us? This is my favorite. And it was like your profile picture for the longest.
Girl, you take, y'all don't want to edit nothing, huh?
Favorite thing. This one. Oh, wait, I don't think it's that one. It's this one.
Oh, y'all like that picture too.
That's my favorite picture. That was her contact picture for a long time. That's like my favorite picture also. I like pictures that, like, I like pictures of us that we take more than, like, pictures that other people take. Like, if people did, I would still like the ones that we take more.
Alright, bro.
The ones that we were actually posting, I don't even think they got posted. Mm-hmm.
Alright, bro. Alright, I'm gonna just say this. A lot of this shit could be edited out. Alright? I understand some people don't like to edit and stuff like that, but a lot of shit could be edited out to make it more entertaining. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes I edit stuff out just to make it more entertaining and just to make the video flow more smoothly. Because people's focus, people's attention spans are like motherfucking like this nowadays. Especially with social media, these little 15 second clips. Niggas be falling asleep in the middle of your motherfucking sentence. All right, I'm just saying.
What are more videos you'll do with me, Ernie?
I don't really
want to do. Oh, Pornhub, sex tape. Okay.
Like, I want to travel. That's why I want to go on my channel. Yeah, I just want to film us like vlogging. Going out of the country and like going to different states and
shit.
I feel like that'd be interesting. If you went
to prison,
what would be your last name?
You don't remember the last thing you ate?
Hello!
I guess I'm saying, like, what would you eat for your last meal before you go to prison?
I do not like pasta for some reason. It's not like I would never eat pasta or never eat spaghetti, but I'm just I am not a pasta spaghetti type of nigga. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't want to come home and be like, babe, food is ready and it's spaghetti or pasta. Like, that's just not a vibe to me. I don't know. I've just never liked pasta like that.
You should know that.
I
did,
but
the Maldives Island.
That bitch is beautiful. I ain't gonna lie to you. That bitch is beautiful. All right, man. I think we've had enough. Okay, guys. Well, y'all leave me a comment down below. Shout out to everybody who made it to the end of the video, okay? Because, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes the struggle be real. You know, I be trying to, you know what I'm saying? I be trying to. Try to make it through, you feel me? You know, shout out to Chrissy motherfucking Danielle and Miss Bila J4K, you know what I'm saying? Look, I don't be trying to shade or nothing like that, you feel me? It's just sometimes I be in a slumber in this bitch, you feel me? I feel like it's a slumber party. We all brought our pillows. Maybe y'all are just two chill ass niggas and, you know, we're just not on your vibe, you feel me? I've got to get on that vibe, you know? Next time I'll bring a pillow and a motherfucking blankie over here. The next time I watch Miss Mila J4K, y'all leave me a comment down below and let me know in the next Miss Mila J4K and Chrissy Danielle video, should I bring a pillow and a motherfucking blanket? Or should I just shoot the shit in my bed? You know what I'm saying? Should I just shoot the motherfucking shit in my bed? Cause you know, it be feeling like a slumber party. And there's nothing wrong with them having a chill vibe. I think a chill vibe is pretty cool, you know what I'm saying? But when it comes to these videos, it's a little difficult to get into it. You know what I'm saying? No pun intended. It's a little difficult to get into it. My camera's about to shut off. I love you guys so much from the bottom of my heart, not the bottom of my balls. I ain't got no goddamn balls. Make sure if you have not already, join the Dynasty, baby. Subscribe to my YouTube channel, like this video, comment your thoughts and opinions down below. Share this video with a friend, hit that bell so you can be notified every time I post another lit ass video. Make sure that you DM me at TheRealDiamondM and let me know what I should be reacting to next. And tell a friend today, ain't your mama today, Uncle Joe. That nigga still a hoe. I will see you guys in the next mother freaking video. I love y'all. Peace. Here we go. I remember I was broke, but I ain't broke no more. I used to